Okay, so in this lecture, I want to spend a little bit of time talking about techniques that biochemists use for separating and analyzing molecules. These are some of the most important things that biochemists do. Some of these are very basic techniques that have been around for many years, and others are much more modern and powerful in their design. So some of the older ones involve some very basic techniques of chromatography. So one of the techniques of chromatography is known as gel exclusion or molecular exclusion chromatography, and you can see it depicted on the screen here. It involves the use of molecules, or I shouldn't say molecules, of actual structures called little bead-like structures, very tiny, maybe about a millimeter or smaller in size, that have various things, various chemicals that are either on their surface or various design features about them that facilitate the separation of molecules from each other. So biochemists are using techniques to separate biomolecules from other things. Well, in molecular exclusion chromatography, it turns out that these beads that we use are something that, if I were to take an individual bead and draw it like that, that's what it would look like. And I have within this bead various holes, okay? And those holes within that bead, and that's what's also shown on the slide here, have a fixed size, a fixed dimension that they will only allow molecules of a specific size to fit into them. So if I have molecules, for example, that are that size, they will fit in, whereas if I have molecules that are much bigger than that, like this guy right here, they will not fit in. Well, why do I care about that? Well, I have a whole column of these beads that you can see here, and there are thousands and thousands of these beads within that column, and flowing through this column is a buffer that just goes from top to bottom, as you can see here. Well, what's that buffer doing? It's moving between the beads and through the beads. That's an important consideration in molecular exclusion chromatography, okay? When I want to, when I have a mixture of molecules, let's say big and small, that I want to separate by this technique, when I apply these molecules to the top of this column, okay, they will interact with the beads in different ways. So let's look at an individual bead right here, and here's two different molecules, a molecule that's small and can fit into these holes, and a molecule that's large and then cannot. These individual holes are like what I like to describe as tunnels. That is, this hole connects to another hole, let's say the one on the side over here. And that creates a pathway through which a molecule that enters the hole can pass, but a molecule which cannot enter the hole cannot pass. What does that mean? It means then that when the molecules are passing through the column in this way, those big molecules that you see here, which cannot enter the holes in those beads, pass not through the beads, but around them, like so, going down, okay? They take a certain pathway through that column. Whereas molecules that are small pass through this bead, and then this bead, and then this bead, and then this bead, and this bead, this bead, this bead, this bead, this bead, this bead. We go back and forth, 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 back and forth. The important point being that molecules that can fit into the holes of the beads travel a longer distance through the column than molecules that cannot fit into there. Well, these holes are what we call the exclusion limit. They're a fixed size. And so we can decide to use beads that have an exclusion limit that might, for example, exclude something of 50,000 in molecular weight or higher, but allow something of 10,000 in molecular weight or lower to fit. Okay? So by picking the right exclusion limit, this exclusion limit might be, let's say, 25,000. It would allow 10,000, it wouldn't allow 50,000. If we had a 25,000 exclusion limit for that size of bead, then we could separate these two molecules. The 50,000 molecular weight molecule would come out of the bottom of the column first, and the 10,000 molecular weight molecule, because it was going through this very contorted path through the column, will come out last. So molecular exclusion chromatography separates on the basis of size. The smallest molecules come out last. The largest molecules come out first.